Everything we call modern life runs on one thing.
But to power the world's second largest economy, we need something massive, constant, and preferably clean.
Well, one of China's answers is out there, on the ocean. One thing that never runs out here, the wind.
China has outbuilt the world in offshore wind. But are these giants powerful enough to keep the lights on for everyone? And what's really behind China's energy shift? In today's video, let's break it down. The coastal city of Yangjiang is famous for its massive wind farms.
Behind me, you can already see these bases for those wind turbines. They are absolutely huge.
But size matters here for a reason, because China is the world's biggest energy consumer. It uses more electricity than the US, India, and Russia combined. How do you power that demand without wrecking the planet? That's the question driving our journey.
It's gonna take us 3 hours by boat to finally get to the wind farms. I mean, why build them so far away in the ocean? It's definitely gonna cost more, obviously.
Wow! It's spectacular. It's breathtaking, this view.
This is one of the world's largest offshore wind farms, and obviously an engineering wonder. How did they pull this off? And once installed, they're built to spin for decades, even through the fiercest typhoons. Imagine the engineering it takes to keep these giants running in the middle of the ocean.
海上的风电和陆上的风电有什么样的区别呢？就是为什么要选择在海上建呢？
它一方面是有风资源不一样的，海上的风资源相对陆上要更好一些。然后第二就是海上的它的那个它使用的是海域的一个面积，然后你在陆上的话，我们都知道这个土地资源还是比较珍贵的，然后它在施工的难度跟施工的工艺方面还是有很大区别的。
One turbine out here can generate enough electricity for about 15,000 people. That's the size of a small town. Now multiply that by hundreds of turbines. Now you start to understand why this matters.
This single farm has over 300 turbines and a total capacity of 2 million kilowatts. That means enough clean energy for 2.4 million homes, cutting millions of tons of carbon along the way. And this is just one of 138 offshore wind farms already spinning along China's coast.
Offshore wind is, of course, a great resource. Of course, it's going to be providing power primarily to those coastal provinces, which are generally more industrialized, more densely populated, and have higher power needs. It's also much more difficult. It's more expensive. The engineering required is a lot more complex. And so as a result, it only really makes sense for a few countries that have really advanced ability to deploy these. And so China is one of those countries, and China is able to do do projects with wind power that other countries might not be able to.
China makes up more than half of global offshore wind capacity. But wind is just one piece of the puzzle. Solar, hydro, and even wave power are part of the mix. Today, over 60% of the country's electricity already comes from clean energy.
And in that regard, China is by far the largest. I think year-over-year growth last year, like 2024, new wind and water and solar altogether was equal to about 500 terawatt hours. That's a very abstract number. So to put that in context, that's, you know, roughly the size of the entire annual consumption of Germany.
The water out here is so charmingly blue. I mean, that says something, right? All the projects they're doing here, all the things they build here, they're not doing any harm to the environment.
Still, not everyone's convinced.
China is expanding its coal power capacity.
Some skeptics picked up a growth in China's new coal power plants and saw that as a setback.
Remember, you can build lots and lots of wind and solar, but because they are intermittent generators, you can't retire any of those coal plants, any of those gas plants, because you still do need them sometimes of the year. You need them in the summer when it's really hot, or in the winter when it's really cold and you have heating and cooling loads.
It's not just about going green. It's about keeping power steady when the wind takes a break. China may reach peak carbon in 2025, 5 years ahead of plan. As the world struggles with climate change, this is proof. A clean future isn't that far away.